As the sun rises on another glorious day, the air fills with the sounds of tweets and twitters. Since the fifth day of the creation of the earth, birds have welcomed the sun each morning with their beautiful, melodious songs. Birds are a unique part of the animal kingdom, with features that make them different from any other vertebrates. Soft, flexible, lightweight feathers are unique to birds. Feathers are made of keratin. The colors and patterns of the feathers provide camouflage or help a bird stand out to a potential mate. Feathers also make it possible to do what few animals can do – fly. The strong outer layer of feathers contours the body, helping birds to fly. Many birds produce oil in a preen gland. The oil spreads along their feathers in order to waterproof them. The inner feathers, called down, trap warm air close to their skin and regulate the bird's temperatures. Feathers easily wear and break, so they must be replaced regularly. Through a process called molting, birds shed old feathers and replace them with new ones. Molts can be partial, where only a few feathers are lost, or complete, where most of the feathers fall out at the same time. During a molt, some birds are unable to fly. The external part of a bird's mouth can be called a beak or a bill, and it is made of bone covered with keratin. A beak is a specialized tool used for building nests, preening feathers, and defending against enemies. But most importantly, beaks are used for eating. There is a great variety in the shapes and sizes of beaks. Differences can be clues as to what a bird eats. Birds are bipeds, meaning they walk on two legs. Bird legs vary in shape and length to match their behavior and environment. Some birds have short, thin legs, which they use to hop. But most of their traveling is done through flight. Larger birds, and some birds that can't fly, have long, strong legs that may be used for running or for thriving in their habitats. All birds have toes with sharp claws at the end. Some claws, as with eagles or owls, are very long, sharp, and powerful. They help the bird catch and kill their prey. We call these claws talons. Most birds have three toes at the front and one toe in the back, though some birds, like parrots, have two toes on the front and two in back. When a tree-dwelling bird perches to rest, a tendon that extends to the toes flexes, gripping the toes around the branch securely. Interestingly, owls and osprey have three toes in front and one in the back when flying, but when perching or grasping prey, the outer toe swivels to the back. The ostrich is the only bird with just two toes, one large toe with a sharp claw and one shorter, clawless toe next to it. Many water birds, like ducks and geese, have webbed toes, where a flap of skin connects the toes and forms a paddle that helps the bird to swim. A bird's leg size and toe arrangement can be good hints about where a bird lives and how it behaves. A bird's forelimbs are called wings. Wings allow for flight in most bird species. Some birds, such as storks or eagles, have broad wings and slots between their feathers that allow them to soar high in the sky for a long span of time. Other birds have pointed wings and quick wing beats that allow them to fly quickly, like peregrine falcons or ducks. Some small birds, such as sparrows or quail, have short, round wings that allow for rapid takeoff and maneuverability to escape predators. Albatross, gulls, and other seabirds have long, slender wings that allow them to soar over the water without expending a lot of energy. Birds that cannot fly still have wings, but either the wing shape or body size is not conducive to flight. Good vision is essential for a bird's survival. Keen eyesight makes up for a relatively poor sense of smell. In the animal kingdom, birds have the keenest eyes in relation to their size. They can see in color and are able to see a wider range of color than humans. Birds that are diurnal, meaning active during the daytime, blink by moving their lower eyelid up over their eyes. Nocturnal birds blink by lowering their upper eyelid. Birds also have a kind of third eyelid, called a nictitating membrane, that helps protect their eyes. This membrane slides from the front of their head to the back, and it moistens, cleans, and protects the eye. The shape and positioning of the eyes of some birds allows them to see a full 360 degrees. They can also see violet or ultraviolet light that humans cannot. Catching sight of a bird soaring across the sky on a warm evening brings a sense of stillness and wonder to the observer. What a view it must be from those heights! How incredible it would feel to glide through the air on powerful wings! The majestic bird is a beautiful reminder of the wonder of God's creation.